This happens to all of us. We wake up one morning and nothing seems to go right. We're sick of our hair, our wardrobe, and our all-around performance. And that impacts our self-confidence. You heard the phrase, dress for success, right? When you dress right, you ooze confidence, plus you get loads of compliments your way. Not just that, people tend to take you seriously when you're dressed for success. So staying on the series of reinvention this month, I wish to take it a notch up and introduce you to one of my friends, Ritu Punjabi, to this channel. So I have with me Ritu, who is a certified image consultant, and she helps professionals dress up for success through her company, Tenure.
Tenure.
So welcome, Ritu, to
Thank
my
you.
Channel.
Thank you so much.
So we have been talking about reinventing yourself, okay?
Right.
That's the theme for this entire month. And today I want to talk to you about how can one reinvent their look,
okay?
Because, you know, like the first thing that, you know, if you look good,
you feel good.
So if someone is to decide, yes, I want to change my look, okay, what do you think that they should immediately focus on? Because not everybody will be in a position to just go and change your entire wardrobe.
Correct, definitely.
Yeah.
So the first thing I would recommend is identify the different occasions and roles that you have to play in your life.
Okay, which is the regular
one. Which is the regular one. So like you have a professional role, you have a social role, you have a personal role. That you
right.
First, identify these roles for yourself and the occasions that you have. Second step is first dig into your wardrobe and see that what is it that is suiting to these roles and occasions or not.
Okay.
Okay, so whatever is not suiting, is not appropriate, is where we really don't need to keep it in our wardrobe. Okay?
Okay.
So that is the second step. The third step would be identify your body type. So see,
right.
As per your body type, what kind of cuts in your wardrobe that you have, that you wear most often and are most comfortable, that is definitely something that is suiting your body type. So yes, so you identify a body type. Again, from the wardrobe, you see which are the styles that are your, you know, best styles. Like whenever you wear them, you feel really good. So
right.
That's your body type identification. Once that is done, when you're looking at starting to build a wardrobe again, my suggestion would be stick to basics and classics to start with.
Right. The red, the blacks,
the blacks, grays, blues, whites,
yeah.
You know, all the dull muted colors, olive greens, chocolate brown, navy blues, burgundies. Stick to these ones to start with and avoid trendy items in the beginning.
Especially in a professional setup.
Especially in the professional setup. So avoid the trendy ones in the beginning. And the reason I say stick to basics and classics at the start is because they are much easier to mix and match.
Agreed.
And you get a lot of variety with a smaller wardrobe in that case. And at the same time, they last you over a period of time. They'll never feel outdated. Once you are satisfied with your basics, then you add on your trendy items.
So is this true even for the gentleman?
Of course. So for the gentleman, the key factor that I see with my clients is that they do have their basics in place, which means it's, you know, they'll have their black and their whites and their grays,
right.
And the blues at the max. They won't add on any more colors. So it will be,
yeah.
You know, the pastel shades of the lemons and the pinks and the lavenders are not there in their wardrobe, which definitely is formal as long as it is made of the correct fabric and it's made of the, you know, the not the darker shades, it's more in the tints, pastels.
Okay.
So they can add that on and still stick to a lot more variety.
So for the guys, I've seen a couple of them wear this
really
bold checkered
yes.
shirts.
Yes.
For work. So
now,
yeah, so I thought I'd make it a point.
So the whole idea for dressing for work should always be that people should not focus on your clothing. People should have a look at your clothing and then like it and forget about it and then focus right here. And with the big bold checks, what really happens is that
pulling the attention
to the clothing and not to the person and what he's really saying.
So they don't tend to be looked that seriously.
Exactly. So the whole distracting aspect really comes with the big bold checks. So I would ideally, checks as a print is not considered formal.
Okay,
so now of course depending on the industry you belong to and you know it being Friday dressing and the business casual dress codes that's coming, so there can be variants.
Yeah.
But as much as possible for men, it should be avoided.
How do we go about choosing the same things in our traditional wear, in salwar kameezes?
When it comes to the Indian kurtas and all those, when you go to buy a ready-made, the thing that you need to see is one, under which brand is the fit really working for you? Because with every brand, the fit is different.
Right.
Plus, within the brands, there will be different styles. One would be the
straight line,
the curly one, all of that. So you need to actually, the first few times that you go shopping, from henceforth, try and figure out which is the brand where the kurta fit is perfect for you.
Okay.
Then further go digging into that brand in terms of the print and the color and things like that.
Right.
So
you need to do homework.
Yes, there's a lot of homework that you need to do.
Yeah, but I think it's comparatively lesser than buying something and not looking good in it.
Oh, yes.
You know, so yeah, because we're looking at reinvention, you're looking at changing the way you want to look and the way you want to make an impact. I think you should invest a little bit of time in doing that.
The biggest advantage that will happen once you are really thorough with this homework is that you will not waste money again.
Yes.
You know, that is a key when it comes to the whole budgeting aspect. Mm-hmm. When it comes to shopping for all of everybody, it's not only my clients, but everybody, the budgeting aspect is the key.
Absolutely.
So here you have to be really wise in terms of picking out things that are really only working for you.
Correct.
So do your homework, get accustomed and understanding of what are your requirements, what are your needs, and then go shopping with a proper shopping list.
Right.
That is the key to all of this.
Right. You decided to reinvent yourself.
Correct.
Clothes are 90% of it.
Correct.
But yeah, there are other areas like, you know, you can get a good haircut,
hair care, nail care, the entire grooming aspect in terms of, understanding what makeup works for you, what kind of foundations work for you, what lipstick shades work for you. These are additional things that to be kept in mind.
So we've given you some dope on how you can reinvent yourself. If you would like to get in touch with Ritu, I will give her details in the description below and you can get in touch with her directly. If you have any further questions on either this video or any other videos in this channel, do leave it in the comment section below, or you can reach out to me in any of the social media platforms that I'm in. And finally, if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. And of course, do not forget to subscribe to this channel. Subscribe and also hit the bell button so you'll never miss an update. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next week.
Thank you.
Bye.